this works at the appropriate time. I'm talking about a real man, not a boy or an adult stuck in transition to becoming a man. So now you know the ingredients to make a real man. Confidence, integrity, courage, and humility. But I must tell you that a real man requires more than these worldly attributes. There must be a spiritual foundation which supports these attributes. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 13 and 11, when I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. I believe what this verse is really saying is that there is an appointed time wherein you can act like a child. You can even reason like a child. But when you make the transition into becoming a man, you no longer do the things that you did as a child. You don't make the same mistakes. You don't act the same. You don't behave the same because now you have grown from a child. And along the way, you picked up some confidence.
Yes, sir.
Along the way, you developed some integrity.
Uh-huh.
Along the way, you received some courage.
Uh-huh.
You are no longer the child that you started off as. But now you are a man, and childish things are behind you. And so this verse affirms that there is a growth process, and that with the right ingredients, a child becomes a man. Putting away childish things can not only make you a real man, it can make you a godly man. A man of God knows that he can find the right ingredients, not in the cookbook, but in the good book. For the ingredients of confidence, he looks up 1 John 5 and 14, which says, and this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. For the ingredient of integrity, he looks up Proverbs 11 and 3, which says, the integrity of the upright shall guide them, but the perverseness of the transgressors shall destroy them. If he wants to find out about courage, he looks to Deuteronomy 31 and 6, which says, be strong and of good courage. Fear not be afraid of them. For the Lord thy God, he goes with thee. He will not fail thee nor forsake thee.
Right.
To gain some humility, he looks to 1 Peter 5 and 6, which tells us, humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. A godly man lives by these ingredients of being a man, but he also prepares young boys to become men. Proverbs 22 and 6 instruct us to train up a child in the way that he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. The great irony is that we lack a sufficient number of godly men to train up our young boys, and we have forgotten that it still takes a village.
Yes, sir.
If we don't train our young boys in the way they should go, the drug dealer will train them in the way they should not go.
Amen.
If we don't train our young boys in the way they should go, the street gangs will train them in a way they should not go. The rap music and hip-hop will train them in a way that they should not go. We must train our young boys the way God says they should go and not the way the world wants them to go. When they go the way they should go, then as they travel the way and pick up a few things along the way, they will have a head-on collision into becoming a man. Along the way, they will pick up some things such as being above reproach, being a husband of one wife, having good temperament, being prudent, being hospitable, not giving to too much wine, being gentle and not quick-tempered, managing his own household well, being free from the love of money, and having a good reputation.
Yes,
all of these things not only make a real man, but they make godly man. What a boy today needs to see a godly man who embodied these traits and characteristics. Yes, in order to be a man, our boys must see a man. And in order for our boys to see a man, we've got to be a man. We must man up to our responsibilities as a husband. Step up to our duties as a father. Measure up to our expectations as a leader. And stand up to our role as mentor. If we stay true to ourselves as man, while displaying the qualities of a man, our boys will see it, and no matter the distraction, peer pressures, or struggles within, they will become men tomorrow, and we will see better families, better communities, and a better world. So let us start today with the right ingredients, building our boys into the man of tomorrow. There can be no substitute for a real man. None of these things can be made up and none come overnight. It takes time, it takes patience, it takes knowledge, and it takes a little wisdom. So if you are wondering when you became a man, I leave you with this poem. When did I become a man? I really need to know. Sometimes I wonder if I am. Can someone tell me so? Was it when I smoked a cigarette out behind the school? Was it when I joined the other guys and acted like a fool? Was it when I took a drink of booze and drove around the town? Was it when I made myself look big by putting others down? Was it when I scored the final play that gave our team the win? Was it when I finally got the A that gave my parents a grin? All right. Was it when I had a hot day and we did it all the way? Was that when I became a man? Did it happen on that day? Was it when I pledged allegiance to the flag and fought a war? Was it when I came back home and wondered what the fight was for? Did it happen in the chapel when I walked the wedding aisle? It seemed to for the moment, if we're judging by my smile. Was it when my kids looked up one day and called me Pop? Or was it when I got the job and made it to the top? So now I am a man. At least that's what I'm told to say. But if I am, there's just one thing that still gets in my way. If so, I have to ask it, and the question drives me wild. But if I am a man, then why do I still act like a child? Thank you, and God bless you.
Come on, give God his hands like a praise in this place.